This free video series about the basics of browser exploitation is supported by SSD Secure Disclosure. If you find a critical vulnerability in a popular and widespread software hardware, for example browsers, my recommendation would be to first contact SSD. On their site ssddisclosure.com, you can also find a list of targets they are generally interested in. So let's say you have found a critical vulnerability on one of those targets, then you can send this vulnerability to SSD. They will confirm and pay you for it and start a responsible disclosure process where they contact the vendor and the vulnerability is responsibly disclosed and published while you still get the credit for it. Not every vendor offers bug bounties for researchers, for example, Apple. Also, other exploit acquisition programs usually do not disclose the vulnerabilities to vendors. So check out their site and make sure to read more about the scope and the submission process. SSD Secure Disclosure is also involved with the offensive security conference TyphoonCon, so keep an eye out for that conference over at typhooncon.com. For several years, I've been whining about that I don't understand browser exploitation. I can imagine that it was quite annoying to constantly hear that for the people that I talk to. I thought that I'm theoretically able to understand this topic, but I kinda resigned and never really tried properly. I remember, for example, the 33C3 CTF where there was a Firefox exploitation challenge, and I thought that would be the perfect opportunity to finally get started with browser exploitation. But back then I already failed with compiling a debug version of Firefox and I gave up. So that means even before that, I thought a lot about getting started with this topic. It has always been kind of a scary topic, I didn't really know where to start. It became really frustrating. Maybe you can relate to this with other topics. The thing is, in some way, it was totally clear to me how to get started with this. I mean, I should just start watching my own video, The Secret Step-by-Step Guide to Learn Hacking, because it applies to this year as well. It just takes time, but it overwhelmed me. You see, I already have experience with the basics of exploitation. I know how buffer overflows work, I know how heap overflows work, and how to do return-oriented programming, and I have somewhat of an intuition for how browser exploitation also works. At least on an abstract level. I just couldn't get myself into it on a technical, practical level. And it's really not the fault of people keeping it a secret or something. There are not tons of resources, but there are probably more than you might think. For example, Saelo's Frack paper on attacking JavaScript engines, or ArcP's article about Firefox exploitation, or CTERT's PlayStation 4 exploit write-ups that included a commented exploit, write-ups from Project Zero, and many, many more. Honorable mentions here should also go to Red2Systems. They have a multi-part write-up about a WebKit exploit they used for Pwn2Own. Unfortunately, I stumbled over it fairly late in my adventure of creating this series, but I think it would have been a great start as well. And beyond all those public resources, thanks to playing CTFs and engaging with the community, I also know several people that could answer questions if I had proper questions for them. And instead of following my own advice at how to not ask a technical question, I annoyed them with questions like, I don't know how to get started. Please help me. I don't understand this. And I got sick of that myself. I hated myself for doing that. And it's about time that I finally take responsibility for myself and approach this properly. I just have to freaking play around with this crap and invest the time that is necessary. I know it will be slow. And it will take time. So after 3 to 5 years of whining around, I think I finally came to the realization that maybe I was just scared of failing at it and I let it overwhelm myself. But then I remembered this was exactly the same feeling I had when I got started with security and war games and CTFs in the first place. And in the end I was able to get into that as well. Look where I am now. So why not repeat that with browser exploitation? And I always tell people, there is no magic to it. It just takes time and persistence and you will learn all this stuff eventually. So I don't know why I was such a hypocrite for not following that advice when it came to this. Then came Congress, 35th C3 in Leipzig, where I saw Jonathan Jacoby's talk from Zero to Zero Day. In there, he talks about his journey to a chakra exploit. And at the beginning, he's referencing my own tweet as one piece of advice to get into this kind of stuff. And also Ned Williamson, in his talk, Attacking Chrome IPC, he reminds me again how much practice this stuff takes, and he shares how he approaches things. So both talks offer excellent advice, and I recommend them you to watch them. They were both major reasons why I decided to tackle this again. So this is my 2019 New Year's resolution, I guess. At the time of writing the first version of this script, it's just 2 days after the Congress, the 31st of December 2018. Berlin is basically a war zone with all the fireworks, and I'm finally going to get properly started. Here's the rough plan what you can expect from the series. This is a huge field with different browser engines and operating systems. Browsers are, next to operating systems, probably the most complex software, including various disciplines from computer science. And then what do you do? Do you look at the DOM, the network layer, or JavaScript? If you go for JavaScript, will you look at V8, SpiderMonkey, Chakra, or JavaScript Core? There is so much. So instead of getting overwhelmed by this, I just have to pick and start somewhere. And like I often say, it doesn't really matter where I start, because this will be a long path and I don't know the path. I just have to start somewhere. And I chose to start JavaScript Core, the JavaScript engine from WebKit, and doing that on my Mac. Here are my reasons. First of all, my CTF teammate, Linus Henze, has recently published an exploit for JavaScript Core and has a proof of concept for Safari, and my Safari version is still vulnerable to it. So I think that is a good start. Also, this exploitation is similar to Saelo's exploit for CVE 2018-4233, which we also have the code for. And Niklas B has an exploit using the same bug Linus uses, but implemented his own exploit. Oh, I mentioned that the first draft of this video was written in December 2018. Well, now it's March 2019, and I'm about to go into production for this video. And actually, just recently, SetDI published a blog post about the same bug from a different researcher's perspective. Additionally, I discovered a German 2-hour-long video recording of Saelos walking through an older exploit in JavaScript Core, which is related to his FRAG paper on attacking JavaScript engines. Also, Saelo has done a few talks on the topic that I've seen already, but I couldn't really apply the knowledge yet. So I also want to revisit them. So all of that makes this bug and all these exploits so interesting to start with, because you can then compare them and each of them will have slightly different angles. To summarize, this video series is about WebKit, which uses JavaScript Core as its JavaScript engine. And I'm also doing this on a Mac, but all of this should also be doable on Linux. Also, if you don't have experience with exploitation, memory, debugging, the stack, heap, etc., it is probably a good idea to start with my binary exploitation playlist first and play some over the wire, Pico CTF, or exploit education challenges. I would also like to mention that this series is not a replacement for proper professional paid training in browser exploitation. Like I described, I just got started with this topic as well, and this video series is documenting my learning progress and methodology. This means I probably will say some wrong stuff, I just really lack the experience. You will see me learning about JavaScript Core from episode to episode, but I hope that it's still a good example of how I approach a new topic. And hopefully I also help you to get started more easily. Anyway, in the first episode we will set up WebKit and JavaScript Core and then learn a bit about the internals and how to use the debugger, and then we slowly make our way through Linus's and Niklas's exploit. So I hope you are as excited for this as I am. And if you like to support the free videos I make, please check out my Patreon or the YouTube membership. I made a video explaining everything that you can find in the description. Thanks. Thanks again to SSD Secure Disclosure for supporting this series. Check out their website and learn more about the SSD Vulnerability Disclosure Program at ssddisclosure.com.